Guys, what's up? It's Spool again. I'm on my way home from work. Pretty tired, so hopefully I don't skip through this video too quick. But I wanted to make a little video about what's been going on with Poison Ivy. I'm getting ready to do some pretty big shit. Time-consuming stuff, which I don't usually like to do because I don't like downtime. I like to be able to just go out to the car, warm it up, and go rip around and get into some boost, you know, some boost therapy. But I've been putting this off for too long. Pretty much ever since I built the car, I've had an image of how I wanted my interior to look like, to feel like. But I've been putting it off because I don't like downtime, and what I want to do is going to take some time. But I figured I'd make a quick video. I'm hoping to be doing some like a vlog for this and see where it goes. I've been wanting to do it for a while actually, but I don't have, you know, like a good camera. And every time I've been in a position to where I could spend $500-$600 on a nice camera, that $500-$600 went right to the car. I just rather spend my money on my car, but see how this goes. I'm just using my phone. I have a Samsung Galaxy Note 8 that I use. It's got a good camera for a phone, but for shit like this, it's not practical. So I apologize ahead of time for the somewhat questionable quality of the videos. But we'll see how it goes, and maybe down the road, if I get into this and it becomes a normal thing, I might invest in a decent camera. But anyway, it's Valentine's Day. I'm actually headed to Tops right now to get some of the most prettiest flowers I could possibly find for my beautiful girlfriend, who is sleeping at home like a normal person and not out at 5 o'clock in the morning on the way home from work like me. And so anyway, we just started this about a week ago, not even a week ago. So this isn't anything that's been going on for a while. But I'm finally tackling the interior. Basically how it's gonna be is the interior is gonna be green. Here's a picture of what the interior was exactly like right before we started. This was literally, took a picture and we started ripping shit out. So you can see it was already pretty gutted. And if you have me on Facebook, whether it be my personal profile or my Spooligan page, you might have seen some updates already about all this. But what we're gonna do is the entire interior is gonna be green. I'm gonna make a sheet metal dash, which is gonna be black. And I'm gonna make some door panels out of sheet metal. But the biggest thing is the wiring. I ripped out all the wiring. Ripped out all the wiring. And there's literally no factory wiring in the car. Actually, right now there's no wiring in it, period. Because it's all ripped out. But we ripped everything out. And my girlfriend slaved away at the sound deadening. She still to this day, I can't find black ice locally anyway. People swear they can get it at your local grocery store, but I've never seen it at any of my local grocery stores. So she found this video on YouTube about using that electronic spray that you would use for like your mass airflow sensor, clean out sensors and stuff like that. And supposedly it works good. So she picked up a couple cans of it and she said it worked good. Not great, I don't think, but she said it, you know, it definitely helped. So she went through it pretty quick. She only had two cans and then she just decided to do the rest the old fashioned way with a screwdriver and a mallet. So that's all out now. So then we started, like while she was doing that, I was doing everything else, pulling everything else out, what was remaining of the dash. What else did I do? The shift cables and the shifter base and just the e-brake cable, battery, taillights, back bumper. I had to remove my battery location stuff. Pretty much everything is stripped right now, so once I get home, I'll show you a little more in detail, but the plan is to get everything out, get everything ready for paint, and paint it, and then hopefully by this weekend, I want the paint to be done completely by Saturday night, so that way I can start making templates for the dash and the door panels. And by the end of the weekend, the dash will be in, and then I can start on the wiring. I'm not going to be using any factory wiring. I'm going to make my own chassis harness. I'm going to be running everything off of relay panels. I'm going to make two of them, probably. One for my chassis harness, and one for my auxiliary stuff, like my fans, my switches, all that kind of stuff, my gauges. So after I get the grocery store here and pick up some flowers, I will head home and show you guys a little more in detail of what's going on. So here's the car. It's all stripped down. Front bumper's off. The fender's off. I had to take all that off, get all the wiring off. And the harness is out for engine bay. Everything's stripped down completely. We got some, this was her idea actually, wrapping paper for blocking off the windows. We still got to do the outside and the outside of the car. Got to get a new windshield. That's from when the hood came up several months back. I forgot the hood pins. It's like the third time that's happened. So anyway, let's jump right into it. So she's been doing some Bondo work. When I took out the rear seat bracket that goes all the way across, it, you can see where it used to attach. It used to attach up around here, over across through there, and back down that side. It was the first time I had ever drilled out spot welds, and I was a dumbass, and it took me a while to figure out that you didn't have to drill a hole completely through the whole fucking car. So I put a bunch of holes in. So she started putting some Bondo there. She loves Bondo. I've actually never even used Bondo before. So she's in the process of covering all the holes, and she's going to sand them down so that way they're nice and smooth. She did both sides. She's doing some down here. I already did some up front. But, yeah, we stripped all the interior out. Then, once that was all out and all sound deadening was out, we used a wire wheel bit on the drill. And I went around with the entire car, cleaned everything up, got rid of all the crud that was left behind. You know, just from dirt piling up in the crevices and the corners and stuff. So the sound deadening under, like on the firewall on this side, is still in there. We gotta take that down. Maybe, I don't know, I might just fucking leave it. I feel bad for making her take all that shit off. She did a hell of a job already. But I cut out the spare tire cover hump thing. Probably gonna be putting in a fusa when I do this, so I cut that out. I'm gonna leave it in there until we get painted, because obviously the fuel tank's right underneath there. So anyway, let me hop in here and show you what my plan is. So, all right, so the dash I'm gonna have come off the windshield. It's gonna come straight out, and it's gonna bend down. And when it bends down, it's gonna line right up with these brackets here. I'm gonna use these brackets for the driver's side, and I'm gonna have to make some over there. That way I have a place to connect that part of the dash to the car. So I figured I'd just leave those and use that as, you know, like my pivot point for where my dash will come and bend down. My dad's got a sheet metal brake, so I can make the bend, but I think what I'm going to end up doing is running a piece of angled aluminum all the way across and make a two-piece dash to where I have a top flat piece and then a flat bottom piece. So that way I don't have to run all the way out to his place to use the sheet metal brake just to make one bend, come all the way back here and hope that it was perfect and not have to go all the way back to his house, because he lives a good 30 plus minutes from me. So I think that will be the easiest route, is just to make a two-piece design. And yeah, so once you get it painted, I'm going to put the dash in. I'm going to make some door panels. I already deleted the lock assemblies on both doors for the most part. You can see I gutted the doors at one point. That was a long time ago when I did that. I left the windows and the power windows. I'm not going to spend all that time and put manual windows in. So I've always used the power windows. So I'll have to wire those up to a switch and mount the switch in a decent spot for when the door panels are on. But I'm going to put door panels on. I'm going to have a pull strap to open doors on both sides. No locks. And then, like I said, a little switch to roll the windows up and down. So I took out the bracket there that was spot welded there for the ECU from the factory that it mounts to the ECU, or the ECU mounts to the bracket. I drilled the spot welds out, and it kind of made a little mess there too in a couple spots. There was actually a bolt from underneath the car. I had to take out a little 10 millimeter. It goes through the heat shield. So that's out. So now one thing that I want to do that I haven't ever seen done before. We've all probably seen a sheet metal dash in a DSM. We've all seen aluminum sheet metal door panels. But what I'm going to do is on the backs here, I'm going to have a piece here of sheet metal, and I'm going to paint it green as well. I'll make a template out of cardboard, and it's going to go all the way across here, all the way to the back into the hatch, and then up. Oops. I guess my battery's too low to operate the flash. So let me get some light here. Okay. All right, let's try this again. So we have the battery, or the battery, the sheet metal. I'm gonna have a sheet metal piece covering all this, basically, from here down, basically from here up. I'm gonna leave because I'm gonna be making a harness bar, because I'm also gonna be using aluminum racing seats in this finally. So I need to have not only a place for my harnesses to attach to, but I need a place to put a mount for the back support of the seats, because they're literally aluminum racing seats that we would use in our dirt cars. So I have a bunch of them, and I love them. They're comfortable, I think, and nobody else thinks they're comfortable, but I'm gonna put a nice cover on it. They're probably both going to be Kirky. I know the one at least is Kirky. I'm not really sure what the other one was, but regardless, they're going to go in. So I'm going to have a harness bar running across. So I don't want to cover that up with sheet metal because I'm going to have to weld a plate to it, or at least bolt a plate to it. I've seen a long time ago on DSM Tuners, a guy bolted the steel plate and then welded. He took the harness bar to a shop because he didn't have a welder, and he had the plates welded on to the harness bar, and then he just bolted the harness bar, the plates to the car. So I can bolt them on until I can get to a welder because I don't got a welder. So that's kind of the plan. Another thing that I'm interested about, or not interested about, but excited about, which is gonna sound kind of stupid probably, but I'm gonna buy some heel plates. I already found one for the driver's side. They're built for 240SXs, but I'm gonna, they don't make that kind of shit for our cars, unfortunately. And I couldn't find any universal ones, so I'm a part of a group. It's called S Chassis, and I fucking love that group. But anyway, before I get too off track, a guy is gonna sell me one for $70 shipped. I can show that a picture to you right now, actually. I don't know what the measurements are yet, but I would imagine it'd work pretty well. Worst case, I had to do some modification to either the heel plate or my floor or something. But yeah, before I got too far ahead with this whole thing, I wanted to start the whole vlog thing. I wish I would have started a little sooner and could have shown some of the work as we were doing all this stuff, but better late than never. So that's pretty much the gist of everything. I have to put new battery cable in for the battery location. Everything that's coming back into this thing is going to be brand new. And where the hell did this thing come from? I have literally never seen it before in my life. Interesting. Interesting. Anyway. Again, the only wiring that's going to be in this car is the wiring that I fucking put into it, which is going to be pretty awesome to be able to say that when this is all said and done. So, pretty excited about that. I've been wanting to do this for so long. So long. It's just, I don't. Usually, when I'm doing stuff with the car, to any car, at least this car, anyway, it's all about under the hood. It's all about going fast and not really about looks. The body's always been pretty rough. I mean, I love it. It's like a ratty kind of look, like a drift style look, which I love. And that's what I'm going to be going for. I'm going to be, I've been talking to a lot of 240SX guys and following the drift scene a little bit, and watching YouTube channels, vlogs, and I can't find the creativity and the inspiration, watching DSM videos anymore, because there aren't any DSM videos. All the DSM videos are like completely just technical stuff and how to do stuff. There's no vlogging, there's no being creative and stuff. It's just, this is how you do this, this is how you do this. It's very serious shit. Whereas a lot of the drift stuff is, it's just fun. It's just work on the car. You have a random idea that you want to put in your car, and you do it, and you have fun doing it. And nobody gives a fuck. Nobody cares. Nobody shit talks people. It's something that I'm really jealous about, as far as like the drift scene versus the DSM world. And like, I'm a part of it too. Like, if a guy posted on eSloop DSM and he was just acting like a tool, maybe
But if he had a body kit, I'd be, you know, if I was in the right mood, I'd be jumping all over him. You know, fucking, oh, you rice or this, rice or that. But it's just different with DSMs. Like, there's, with DSMs, there's a way to do things, and that's the only accepted thing you can do with DSMs. But fuck that. So I've been wanting to do this. It's kind of like, you know, like a race car thing. But at the same time, I want to have some fun with it. I wanted to put some, like, cool shit on it, like HID projectors, inside headlights. But I was thinking about literally deleting the headlights and just making them out kind of where these are and having them sit there. But if this was a 1GA and had pop-ups, I would definitely do it. I don't really see it working well with a 1GB, but that's just, you know, stupid shit. Like, ideas like that is what I want to start doing. I want to have, you know, like with the projectors, even if I put them inside the headlights and get some nice clear covers, you know, I want the whole strobing effect. I want the fucking party lights. Inside the car, I have been so gung-ho about putting LED strips up in the car, like really bright LED strips to have ample lighting in the car when I'm in the car at night and I need to see or something. Instead of the little puny dome light, I'm going to have a switch wired up to some really bright LED lights, so the entire car illuminates inside. But at the same time, you know, maybe get some fucking cool LED fucking bling bling party lights. Just do some fun shit. So, we'll see how it goes. But before it got too far ahead, I wanted to start the whole vlog thing. I'd love, you know, who doesn't love a good vlog? It's fun. Like, nobody wants to read anymore. And I'm still going to be doing my project log stuff on my website. But, I don't know. I've been so gung-ho. I've been, honestly, it's just, I've been around the 240 guys, the you know, the drift scene. And I'm so jealous how fun they have. So I'm trying to do shit to have fun for myself and have fun for you guys. And, you know, have some fun with the DSM, because nobody has fun with DSMs anymore. It's just how it is. But, most of us are doing shit behind the scenes and not really talking about it and doing our own thing, keeping ourselves. So, we'll see how this goes. Maybe, yeah, I'll do two videos and I feel like it sucks, so I won't continue with it. But maybe I'll do it, and then maybe few months from now, I'll get a nice camera and really start and put some fucking time and money into it. And, I don't know. We'll see what happens, but, I'm gonna let you guys go. I got the flowers for the old lady. They're in there. So, I'm gonna go wake her ass up, tell her how much I love her, and, give her some pretty banging ass flowers. And, hopefully she likes them. So, What do they say? Subscribe to me, give me thumbs up, whatever. I'm gonna be doing some videos. So, just stick with me. And, you know, once we get going with the videos and the car, especially once this thing starts coming around, it's gonna be a lot of fun. So, subscribe. Yeah, I look forward to this stuff. So, you guys, you know, take it easy. Keep building your cars. Keep building some race cars. And have fun with it, man. See you guys later. Till next time.